Hello, this is Sunny from My Happy Space. Welcome back at my channel. We are going to do our first meditation sheet for this month's memory verse. We are looking at four verses that you can say or pray in the mornings before you start the day, before you do Bible study. The first one we're looking at, incline my heart, and then we look next week at open my eyes, teach my ways, and satisfy me in the mornings. So this is incline my heart to your testimonies and not to selfish gain. So the first video of each month is always just slightly a little bit longer because I'm just quickly explaining to you where I get this information from for the newbies who's here. First of all, what I do is I write down our verse at the top end. And I obviously we are memorizing the ESV version. So this is the ESV version, and it is incline my heart to your testimonies and not to selfish gain. I just put the ESV and Psalm 119 verse 36. Then I look for two different translations. Now you don't have to look at in the way I do it. You can just look at different Bibles, you can actually just Google it, whatever you want. But this is just one place you can find everything. It's Bible Hub, and this is the icon, it's like a little book that opens. So obviously it will look different in different places. So it opens, it is already at Psalm 119 because obviously I was working in Psalm 119, but usually there is a Dropbox boxes, so there's a little arrow there, then all the books of the Bible come. So obviously we're already in Psalms, then it drops down there, you look for Psalm 119, and then you drop down again, and then obviously we're going to look at Psalm 36. So 119:36. So I click on that, and then it gets to there. Then it usually opens in the parallel version, but I'm just going to press there. It's a parallel version, meaning the verses is parallel or underneath each other. It's different translations, so it gives you immediately. So I just go through there and I look at two verses, other verses that or translations that stood out for me. You get obviously now very word for word translations, which is very directly translated word for word, which is the King James, the ESV, I think the New American Standard Bible is also like that. Then you get more the word for thought translation, a bit looser translation, NIV. All these translations I'm talking about is good translations. There's nothing wrong with them. It's just different ways. The New Living Version is a little bit more thought for thought. It's a more easier reading language. I do actually my personal Bible study in the New Living Translation because English is my second language. So I just like to have a good read, especially if I read through this Old Testament or books like Romans, which has got lots of doctrine and complicated things. I like to read it in an easier language, but I study mainly from the ESV and I memorize scripture from the ESV. So here's the verses. So I chose the NLT. I mostly chose the NLT and the NIV. I'm just going to write down the NIV. Sometimes I choose something else, but this time, yet again, it was just two different ones. The NLT says, give me an eagerness for your laws rather than love for money. So obviously, later in the next verses underneath, they talk about coveting things. So obviously, I think that's the idea where they get love for money. Yet is turn my heart towards your statutes and not towards selfish gains. It's very much the same. Instead of testimonies, it's the statutes, and turn instead of incline. And then obviously, yeah, it's more give me. It's more plain language. Give me, and the eagerness. We know when something's to do with our heart, it's going to be with our enthusiasm, our eagerness. So that's basically what it is. So when I've done that, I go to the 5 W's and 8's. Now, the 5 W's and 8's, you can also get it at various places. You can get some of the information here. Like, for instance, you can go to commentaries. You can go to time. Like, for instance, if you press on time, it will give you a timeline, more or less, when the verses is, or the Psalms is written. As is, you can Google it, whatever you want to do. I often find sometimes my things in here. It's called the Bible Travel Guide, which is more for teenagers, but it's quite like this. If you work in Micah, then it gives you all the author, the purpose, when was it writing and everything. So you get all the information from there. This time I got mostly my information. I always listened after I done the memory verse or the verse mapping. I usually listen to a sermon. I tend to listen to David Guzik. He's gone through the whole Bible. And his sermons are short, to the point, and very powerful and spiritful. So I just like to listen to him. Obviously, you can listen to anybody or what you think is a good teacher. So he told me, I first went to the introduction of Psalm 119. He had a whole video about that. And then I went to my specific section where we are going to look at, and then I listened to the Samhita there. So I got most of the information here. Basically, nobody knows really who wrote Psalm 119. Yet again, I was always under the impression it is David who wrote it. Lots of people think it might be David, but they're not 100% sure. It doesn't say, so we can't say for sure. What is the context? Now, the interesting thing is, this is a type of psalm that was written that each section started with a different letter of the alphabet. So there's 22 sections in Psalm 119. And we are working in the fifth section of the Hebrew alphabet. And it's not going to be the sound H, because H is not in the Hebrew alphabet, but it looked like H. It's almost like he or something like that. But that is where we are. So basically, each word in that section of the psalm starts with that letter. So that's interesting. And another interesting thing is about the Psalm 119, the collection, is that out of the 176 verses, 171 of those verses mention the word of God. So obviously it's a celebration of the word of God. So that's very interesting. So basically that's a context that we look at the fifth section out of 22 sections. When was it written? Yet again, because people are not sure, if it was David, it could have been over the course of his life. Other people say it is after the exile, after they came back from Babylon. So then obviously that will put it in a certain time period. Doesn't really matter. It's just interesting to look at it. Where did it go? Obviously it went to God, a prayer to God. It went to maybe to the temple. And obviously ultimately it went to go to us. And why was it written? Specifically this verse is to have that contrast between where our hearts and attention should be and where it shouldn't be. Like, incline my heart to your testimonies. And the opposite of that is, so I don't have any selfish gain. Not to have selfish gain. So it's a contrast between that. So it just shows us what it is about. So before we going to look at the strong words, let's quickly read that section. That is just a few verses. And as you can see, it is broken out like that in the Hebrew, in the Bible. And as you can see, that is the letter of the alphabet which they're talking about. Now, our memory verse of this month is called Morning Prayers. And here, I've actually a long time ago, I said Daily Prayer. Now, this whole section can be a daily prayer. Obviously, two of our verses we look at is going to be at Psalm 119. So there's so much to be seen and understood. I mean, every time I read Psalm 119, I'm just absolutely blown away by the richness, the love for the Word of God, the importance. So obviously, it starts with, teach me, O Lord, the way of your statutes, and I'll keep it to the end. Before we actually go, before I go on, there is 7 to 8 different ways that the writer talks about the Bible or the Word of God. The one that is mentioned the most 25 times is the law of God. And that is almost like the written law. Then 24 times is the Word of God. And that is almost like talking about the spoken word of the Lord. Now, judgment is a third highest amount of times it talks about the word of God in the form of judgment. And then 23 times testimonies. And obviously, that is the one we are looking at. And that was said 23 times. 22 times is commandments. And then the sixth highest amount of time it talks about the word of God is according to statutes. Then 21 time it's called about precepts. And that is to me like the standards where you build on top of each other. I do inductive Bible study with the ministry precepts from Kay Arthur. That's obviously where that comes from. Last one is a sort of a collective word. It's also the word of God, but it's a collective word. And that's, so yeah, let's read it. It says, it talks to start with, teach me, give me your understanding, lead me. And then obviously our words, incline my ears. And it's interesting, David Guzik said that you never have to teach somebody to sin. People just automatically sin. You never have to say, oh Lord, teach me to sin. But we need to make that conscious decision. We need to ask the Lord to give us that desire, to teach us to keep his statutes, to give us understanding so we can keep his law with our whole heart, to lead us in the path of righteousness. I mean, that is beautiful. It talks about, I think, Psalm 23 also, he will lead me to the path of righteousness. And so we can delight, and it doesn't come natural. Our flesh is kicking in the whole time against that. And then obviously it says, incline to my heart to your testimonies and not to selfish gain. And that is when I said it is that contrast, that incline, it's turn my heart. It's not like you always need to replace the one thing with the other one, because the next verse is, turn my eyes from looking at worthless thing and give me life in your ways. So it's not, he didn't ask the Lord to close his eyes to make him blind because he's so worried. I mean, that's the only way he can actually look upon the Lord and not have selfish gain. No, it is turn, make that decision, turn. And I always say, if you want to get rid of a sin in your life, you have to replace it with something. And the best thing to replace it with is the Word of God and God's presence. So forget about your sin for the moment. Don't think, oh, I'm never going to gossip, or I'm never going to get angry again. Because the more you concentrate on that, actually it's going to happen. But if you almost put it on ice for the moment, say, all I'm going to do for the next week is just spend more time in the Word of God, ask the Lord to help me, seek his presence, incline my heart to him, all those type of things, then automatically you will turn your eyes. The Lord will give you the desire, the delight, to be able to incline your heart to him and not to selfish gain. And as I said, turn my eyes from looking to worthless things. So that is the contrast. I mean, the selfish gain, the things that we think is important, which we want to pursue, most of the time it's worthless things. And that's something we need to ask ourselves. Lord Jesus, I want my heart to be focused on you. I want to turn my eyes towards you so I don't get consumed by selfish gain and by worthless things. So you will give me my life in your ways. I want to live according to your ways. And then confirm to your servant your promise that you may be feared. Yet again, turn away the reproach that I dread, for your rules are good. To understand that God's rules are good. Confirm the promises. And that confirm is like establish the Word of God. And another thing is, when we read the Word of God and we feel like, oh, we don't agree with it, or we feel like, oh, I don't understand it, why did God say that? You are wrong and God is right. You need to confirm God's Word in your heart. You mustn't change God's Word or take some of it away. No, you need to confirm God's heart in your life, or Word in your life. And then, behold, I long for your precepts, in your righteousness give me life. And in the King James Version, that life is revive. So he says, revive me. For us to be revived, to ask to be revived, this is what we need to do. We need to spend time in the Word of God. We need to incline our heart. We need to ask the Lord to teach us, and we need to look away, turn our eyes away from worthless things and start focusing on what God wants and his things that is worthwhile in life. So that is how we can revive ourselves and get new life in Christ. So that is the context of Psalm, the section we do, so from verse 33 to 40, and our memory verse is obviously verse 36. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to look at the strong words. Now, if you don't know what the strong is, for each word in the New and Old Testament, there's a number connected to it that takes you back to the original Greek or Hebrew word, and that is what the strong's number is. It's named after a man. I think he developed it. He said, I'm a strong, as far as I remember. So I've decided there's so few words. There's plenty of space. Obviously, I wanted to look at incline. I wanted to look at heart. I wanted to look at testimonies and selfish gain. So that's what I look at. So where you get it in here is, obviously, if you've got your parallel version open, you see this, it says Strong's there in lexicon. You can press on both. If you go to Strong's, it will just give you the strong words, the original Hebrew words with the number, what it means. I just always go to the lexicon because I just like how it looks. It's underneath each other. It makes sense to me. There's less busyness. So that's what I choose, but it's the same. So obviously I'm now at Psalm 119 verse 1. So I just need to go to 36. I don't know. Sometimes it jumps back to the original. So inclined. And then the word is 5186. I don't know if you can see it. 5186, and then it gives you sort of more explanation about it, like to stretch out, to spread out, extend, incline, and bend. But when you press on it and the blue, so then it will take you to a different page, which is a little bit more detailed. Then it gives you loads of places how it can be used. It gives you references in the Bible where it has been used. So that's where I get my information from. So obviously, as I said, to incline is to stretch out, to spread out, to bend, to extend, to turn, to visit. It's interesting, the visit is to spend time there. It is something that's going to be slow. You spread it out, you extend, you linger there. It's not something that's going to happen quickly. And actually, it's the same word, they pitch your tent in Genesis 26:25. And that was interesting. It's a place you stay at. You don't quickly go by. You incline your heart. So it's time. It's slow. So that was quite interesting for me to read that. My heart is 38:20. And I looked at previous places where we looked up that exactly. When we did, in the beginning of the year, we memorized 4 verses about a heart, a new heart. And Ezekiel 36:26 is, give me a new heart and remove my heart from stone and take and give me a heart of flesh. So that was the same heart. And Psalm 51:10 is also creating me a new heart. So those times it was exactly the same word. So your heart is your inner man, your mind, your will, your attention, your concern, what you consider, what you determined. So this is what you need to do. Your inner man, what's going out and inside, your attention, what you give attention to, you need to incline to the Lord. What you concern about, what you consider, what you determine, all those things where you fix on what's important to you, that you need to give to the Lord, incline to his testimonies, what he says. And that is why it says here in the NLT that your eagerness, what you feel enthusiastic about, what can make you excited, you need to incline it to the testimonies of the Lord. Now, testimonies is laws, statutes, admonitions, ordinance, warnings. So look towards those things that the Lord says. He gives us warnings, he gives us commands, he gives us statutes and law for a reason, because it says then, one of the verses says that your judgments are right. And the law of the Lord is perfect, reviving the soul. That's also one of the verses we've memorized previously. So that's what I got from there. And the root word is at, and it's to return, to go about, to repent, to do it again. So that is your testimonies is almost a repeat. It's to do it again, to go back to it. Those things that we know the Lord wants us to do, go back to that. Now, selfish gain is 12:15. So it was sort of in a negative context, in plunder, dishonest, violence, but it's also something like profit. So basically, incline my heart to your testimonies, not what I think is going to be profitable, not what I want to do, and dishonesty or gain or plunder. It's not like I want to collect these things. And that's probably why it talks about money in the NLT version, because they're looking all over what it means to have selfish gain. So then I looked up words where it stands incline in the Bible. And I got to Psalm 141 verse 4, and it says, let me incline my heart or my ears, my heart to evil. So just as we want to incline our hearts to God's testimony, so we also shouldn't do it towards evil. And then also another one is in Isaiah 37 verse 17 is, incline your ears So we can incline our hearts, but we also can incline our ears, and we can actually incline our eyes also. That's something that we also need to do, to spread it out, extend it, turn towards it, pitch our tent there where the Lord is. And then Proverbs 22 verse 17, incline your ears to my prayer. So we can ask the Lord also, Lord, listen to my prayers, visit me, stay with me, listen to my prayers. So that is where I find incline. Then cross-references, a good place to get cross-references is when you go back to the parallel version. Finches Mark 7 verse 21, it says, for from within the heart of men come evil thoughts, sexual immorality, theft, murder, and adultery. That is what we incline to, selfish gain. So we need to ask the Lord to change our hearts and give us a desire. As I said, nobody ever have to tell anybody how to sin. It just comes natural. And Luke 12 verse 15, guard, and he said, what's up? Guard yourself against every form of greed. For one's life does not consist in the abundance of his possessions. And Hebrews 30 verse 5, which is one of my life verse, is keep your life free from the love of money and be content with what you have. For God says he will never leave and forsake you. So all these things that we rather should incline our hearts. Psalm 119 verse 112 is, I have inclined my heart to perform your statutes even to the very end. And 1 Kings 5:58 is, may he incline your heart to himself, to walk in all his ways, and to keep the commandments and statutes and ordinance he commanded your fathers. So that was a prayer. So that is, yeah, the concept behind it. So I hope that was useful. That is definitely a prayer we can pray in the mornings before we start our Bible study. Lord, incline my heart to your testimonies, because it doesn't come natural to have the desire to spend time with the Lord, to do his will. It's something we need to ask the Lord constantly. And it reminds me of a verse in Philippians 2:13. I like the NLT version of it. Pray, I often pray for my kids. It says, for God is working in you, giving you the desire and the power to do what pleases him. I think in the ESV it says the will to do what pleases him. So I ask the Lord to give me the desire, but not just the desire, but also the power to do what pleases him. It's something I need to ask him. It's not going to come natural. So desire and power. So this verse is very much the same. Incline my heart to your testimonies and not to selfish gain. So yeah, have a great day, and yeah, I'll talk to you on Friday where I can do an entry in my Bible. I'm going to load a freebie on my private Facebook group. So if you haven't joined my private Facebook group, there's a link down below. I'll just ask you a question and then I'll let you in the private group. And then there's a file section where there's loads of freebies. So I'm going to load a pattern paper freebie for this month's printable. So yeah, go and pick that up, and then we can do something pretty in our Bibles or wherever you are. I'm going to obviously take my free points, use the ephemera, and actually put my free points also in there. So thank you very much for joining me. I really appreciate it. God bless, and bye-bye.